Dacono City Council, April 11, 2016, regular meeting to order and ask everyone for, or ask Val for a roll call, please.
Carl Randolph.
Here.
Peggy Randolph.
Present.
Nick Vogel.
Here.
Kevin Kling.
Here.
Robin Dunlap.
Here.
Debbie Nasta.
Here.
Joe Baker.
Here, we have a quorum established, and ask everyone in the audience to please join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Right. Thanks, everyone. I appreciate that. I've asked Don Hatta from St. Brain Valley Schools to give us just a hi, a reintroduction, and see how he's doing. I've met with him a couple times, and just I don't know if any of the council members know him. So, Don, if you would please take a few minutes and come up and tell us who you are, I'd appreciate that.
All right. Well, thank you, Mayor Baker and City Council members. I appreciate the time. My name is Don Haddad, and I'm the superintendent for the St. Brain Valley Schools. And I have been, as I do often, going to all of the different areas within our school system and just providing an update. And so I wanted to make sure and do that for the city of Dacono as well. So I'm going to just share with you a little bit of information and go from there. As you probably know, we are currently the seventh largest school district in the state of Colorado out of 178. When I started in this role, we were the 10th largest. And we have 32,000 students right now, and we are growing by about 800 to 1,000 students every year. And so sitting at 32,000 right now with our ultimate build-out plan for 85,000. And our district right now spreads out over 411 square miles. We include, obviously, the city of Dacono, Firestone, Frederick, Meade, Lyons, Longmont, Erie, and Niwot. So that's kind of the lay of the land where we are. One of the things that I'm really proud of, and we're really proud of in terms of partnership with all of our communities, is the way in which we support each other. And one of the things that we've seen is a lot of the growth is as a result of communities that are strong. It's as a result of a school system that's strong. It's attracting and helping to attract businesses and corporations and create jobs. You know, recently I did a presentation at the State Economic Development Council, and I think we took a little bit of a different tact. Rather than talking about class size and things, we really had a great conversation about how a strong school system, a strong public school system, serves to strengthen an economic presence in any community, and that a strong school system strengthens and enhances school safety and community safety, and that a strong school system creates jobs and raises the value of homes, and it creates a quality service industry. And these are the kinds of things that we're trying to ensure and provide for every single one of our communities throughout the entire school system. Our kids are doing really well. We've seen achievement levels rise, not only with test scores, we've seen them rise with attendance rates. We've seen our discipline rates come down. We've seen all kinds of state championships with athletics, music, debate, you name it. Our kids are doing really, really well. And we're sending them out into the workforce with a great head start. Right now, one of the exciting things, and I'll just focus here on the Carbon Valley area, what we're seeing is enough growth that in the next cycle, we're probably looking at building another school, another elementary school, and then also adding on to the high school in the area. And we may even be building two schools in the area, depending on how quickly the growth continues to develop. But what we're also seeing, and if you look at the pre-K through 12 evolution in this particular area, we have added Spark Discovery Learning Center, which is a state-of-the-art early childhood center in partnership with IBM. It's the only one in the state of Colorado. We have added, obviously, the new high school to the area. We have renovated the old high school to a great K through 8 system. And we've done significant renovation to the other schools that already existed. And again, we're looking to build new schools. Right now, when we look at the kids that are leaving our system at the high school level, we now have hundreds of kids that are leaving the high school as a sophomore in college because They've taken care of all of their freshman-level college credits free of charge to the student before they graduate. And we're on the cusp right now of implementing a new program. It will be the first in Colorado, and it's called PTEC. And it's a program in partnership with Front Range Community College and IBM, where our high school students can stay in the high school for 2 more years. So they graduate with their high school diploma. They stay for 2 more years. They earn a college degree, 2-year college degree at no cost to the student. And then they are put first in line for jobs at IBM and other major corporations throughout the state. And we were selected, St. Vrain, by IBM, not the local IBM, but the national IBM, because of the work that we've been doing with our school system. And that's going to be a one-of-a-kind opportunity for our kids to be able to graduate, earn their college degree at no cost to them, and walk right into a job regardless of the field. Whether it's a vo-tech job, or they want to go to a 4-year college afterwards, whatever it is that they choose to do. And so we're very, very proud of that. And these are the kinds of things that we're doing in our school system. And I appreciate the support. I know that Dacono is growing very, very fast. And we want to be a great school system for you and make sure that we provide for your children and our children the very best education that they can receive anywhere in the nation. That's our objective. And working together, I think that we can accomplish that. So I appreciate your time tonight.
Okay. Thanks, Don. I know that we have spoken also. I think that there was another exciting thing that you told me about with the, that it was a homeschool.
Absolutely.
I think that was really exciting to hear some of that, because I know some people do some homeschooling. So.
Well, and I appreciate that, Mayor. One of the things that we're very proud of is we offer lots of choice in this district. We have neighborhood schools, we have charter schools, we have online schools, and we have the largest homeschooling program in the state of Colorado and the most successful one. We now have 800 students, and they're in 3 locations. One of the locations is Rocky Mountain Christian Church here, and then another one is Vine Life Church down south, and another one is the Life Bridge Church on the northern part of Longmont. But again, it's the largest homeschool program in the state, and what we believe is that, you know, homeschooling is such a viable option for our children that we didn't want to separate them and not have them have access to all of the wonderful amenities that they couldn't get at home. So it's kind of like a hybrid model, and it's outstanding. And if any of you ever would like a tour in any of our buildings, I would be more than happy to take you there and show you the absolute state-of-the-art learning that is going on. And I know I'm the superintendent, and I know I could be accused of being biased, but this is what you will hear from anyone in the state, anyone in the country. Pull up our website and look at what the White House is saying about your school district. Pull up the website and see what the state of Colorado is saying about your school district. And we're very proud of that. And we're also very grateful to the kind of community that you've created here, which makes people want to move to this area. So again, I really appreciate your time. And hopefully I can come back again another time and continue to give updates as I do in all of our communities. So thank
Thanks,
you very
Don.
Much.
Thanks, Don. Really appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Take care.
See you guys later.
All right. It was nice to do that. Nice to get an update from the area. Some of that stuff's really exciting, so I really wanted the council to kind of see that whole activity. I got a chance to meet with him and see some of that stuff going on, and I was excited enough to ask him to come in and give us an update. So appreciate your time with that, council. Moving along to the agenda, I see that April the 16th, I was reading some notes that Habitat for Humanity was taking volunteers. So I'm taking you next, but can I pull her up here for one more second? And sorry about that. These are, I just wanted to get an update. I read something, and I know you needed us Saturday. I just didn't get the time. So reintroduce yourself to the council, if you don't mind, please.
I'm Nicole Stanek. I presented, I think it was 2 months ago, about our neighborhood revitalization work that we're doing in the Glens here in Dacono, which is an asset-based community development approach to working with the community. And so we had a very successful survey day back in February. Lucky to have 70 degree weather on a Saturday in February. So we're hoping for to keep the rain away for this Saturday. That last one was on physical conditions observations, and so we just got all of those inputted into a database, and I'll be kind of analyzing those and can give you an update once I have that. Our next upcoming survey, and I know that that you all did a survey of your own, but this is going to be a resident feedback survey, and so we're looking for volunteers to help us out going door to door and asking residents of the Glens for their input on and feedback on the neighborhood and their perceptions of the neighborhood, hopefully to help form the plan, neighborhood plan that we have for our neighborhood coalition that we're working on forming. So the it is this Saturday. The time is 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. And we're taking volunteers of any age.
Where?
You can meet at our office at 909 Glen Heather Court. The tiny teal building is my office, about the color of my jacket. Mm-hmm. And I do have some flyers here, if that would help.
Just pass them out there, just hand them down.
Sure. So yeah, volunteers of any age, especially helpful if bilingual, but if not, we'll have translated materials and things like that. So if you know of any high school kids, I know that I presented at Frederick High School, and unfortunately this weekend is prom over there, so they were pretty busy, but great opportunity. So.
Awesome. Okay.
Thanks.
Thanks for the update. Appreciate you taking the time to come up and say hi to us again. So.
Of course. Any questions?
Good.
Did you see
who's
going around this Saturday?
This Saturday, yes. We'll be
out in the Glens. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. All right, thanks again. Good seeing you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Council, for your time on that, too. It's another passion. I'm sorry about that. Come on up. Come on up, sir. I apologize. So kind of curveball the Council with some of those announcements. So
I'm Lee Affman. I live at 6099 Viewpoint Avenue in Firestone. There's two things I'd just like to bring up tonight. The first one is, and we've talked about this before, is the Veteran Stand Down Day, or Veteran Appreciation Day, that's coming up April 29th, Friday. And it's coming along okay. And what I'm here tonight is to invite you all, or some, or whoever can attend, because we're going to have a 10 o'clock appreciation ceremony for veterans. It's 10 o'clock a.m. And we have Ken Buck's office coming, we have Corey Gardner's office coming, and we have two county commissioners committing to come. And we'd like to have the town of Dacono also representative, if the mayor can't, somebody else can. So far we've had some donations for breakfast and lunch and so forth, but things are rolling in. You have Daylight Donuts here. I have to commend her, because the minute she heard about it, she says, I want to help. And there she was. There was no questions asked. So compliments to her. The American Legion is donating some chairs, loaning some chairs and tables for us. However, we're about 15 or so short. And if you would know of any organization that has tables and chairs that they could loan to us, we would come and pick them up and so forth. So I guess I'm asking if a network out there, if you know of some, okay? And they could give me a call at home, and we'd come and get them. My home phone number is 303-682-2369. One major thing that's coming is a medical semi with doctors and nurses on there for veterans to get physicals and whatever else they need, and some direction medically wise. It's not only for homeless, it's for all veterans, no matter where they are in life. Second item I have is there may be some people here that do not know of our Agency on Aging lunch program for seniors that we have at the rec center Tuesdays and Thursdays for all seniors. The meal is cooked at the University of Greeley, UNC, and brought down to us hot. And we're all volunteers. Nobody gets paid. And what I'd like to suggest is somebody, if you'd like to come and check us out, I guarantee that you'll be treated right, you'll have a good time, and you'll go away well fed. So what I would suggest for seniors in the area to call us. And like I said, we're all volunteers. Nobody gets paid. And in fact, I just had some volunteers, four of them exact, to come up to me and say they're going to have to leave because they needed to move to senior housing. So they're moving to Longmont. And so they even apologized for not being able to help anymore, but they had to move to Longmont because there is no housing for them in this area, in the Tri-Town area, or in the Carbon Valley area. That's another topic for something else. So, but to that end, we had three people step up and at the end of the luncheon say, "Lee, how can we help?" And I want to commend Carl and Peggy because they were two of them that came up and they are now full bona fide volunteers of our program, and we really appreciate the fact that they stepped up so quick.
Very nice.
Any questions?
Thanks, Lee. Appreciate your time. Thanks, Council, for listening to Lee. Okay, any other public comments not on the agenda this evening? Had a full run, didn't we? Okay. All right, seeing none, we'll close that section and we'll move to the consent agenda. The following items for the consent agenda are considered to be routine business matters by the council that can be decided without decision, or excuse me, discussion. Apologize. Do you need a decision? Been in trouble last year for that one, didn't we? So, wow. And will be enacted with a single motion and a single vote. Those items are the minutes for the March 2016, March 28th regular meeting, accounts payable for April 11th, 2016 in the amount of $238,172.76, and approval of Resolution 1618 approving the June 2016 Almost Free Building Permits Program. Council, it's back in your hands.
I move to approve the consent agenda as read.
Second.
Motion by Plain, second by Vogel. Look for a vote, please.
Carl?
Yes.
Peggy?
Yes.
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes. Okay, that motion carries with everyone saying yes. Next is a opening of a public hearing for approval of Resolution 1619, approving the amended and restated service plan for Eagle Meadows Metropolitan District. Subject to the amendment, I need a motion to continue the public hearing from, oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah,
looks like we're continuing that till Monday.
Script. So. We're going to be continuing this.
So we're just going to open the public hearing first and then ask for a motion to continue the public hearing now.
Correct.
And then we'll move forward with the hearing part and then continue it till April the 25th.
No, there will be no hearing tonight.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll look for a motion to continue the public hearing to Monday, April the 25th at 6 p.m. so the City Council may consider additional evidence, including a report from the city's consultant who is reviewing the proposed financial plan.
And I move that the City Council continue until Monday, April 25th, 2016 at 6 p.m. the public hearing on the proposed amended and restated service plan for Eagle Meadow Metropolitan District, and that the city staff be directed to prepare any further revisions to the draft resolution of approval of the service plan for council review at that time.
Okay, motion by Plain, second by Carl Randolph, and look to receive a vote, please.
Peggy?
Yes.
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Carl?
Yes.
That motion carries with all saying yes. Next on the general business is consideration for the reappointment of Judge Hardesty. And then also we're appointing the three other associate judges today.
Yeah, if I could just kind of clarify for council and everybody. The charter language is clear that we council appoints a municipal judge every year. There is not a provision for alternates or backups. We had one, she's no longer available. So Judge Hardesty went and got three of his colleagues that are judges that would be willing to pinch hit if he was not able to. Now I will tell you, since he's been our judge since, 2009, the police department and he have kind of rearranged the schedules to make sure. So it would be infrequent that we use these, but rather than calling an emergency meeting if we know we need an alternate, we thought it'd be prudent to just appoint these associates also while appointing the judge. So that's what this is about.
And I think background on him is Judge Hardesty has been with us since 2009. It looks like he's been our judge since our last one. He's done a I know he's got an excellent job because you received that from the courts. So, questions?
Yeah, how does the payment work out for the three other judges?
Well, we have an agreement with Judge Hardesty that's just a flat fee per month. I mean, off the top of my head, I would say we just continue the same rate of pay if they came in. He didn't get down into the details on that with them.
Okay.
Do we have to name the judges, the associates?
Yes.
So do you want a single motion administration but to appoint the judge and then the three associates all in a row and a vote so that we're not individually appointing each one of these? So you'd like a motion to appoint Judge Hardesty to another one-year term starting effective today until 2017, correct?
Correct.
And then you'd like with an additional appointment of associate judges, Louis Gresh, Diane Knudsen, and Jeffrey Kahn as associate judges.
So the motion is to reappoint Judge Hardesty for a one-year term beginning today. Is that correct? In addition, you want the completion date?
No, that's fine. Okay.
In addition, associate judges Louis Gresh, Diane Knudsen, and Jeffrey Kahn for the same term.
A second.
Okay, we have a motion by Debbie Nasta, a second by Kevin Plain, and look to receive a vote, please.
Nick?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Carl?
Yes.
Peggy?
Yes.
That motion carries with all saying yes.
So I apologize for those late additions. That's, now that we get the packet out on Thursday, these things kind of came up on Friday, so it was just a little awkward to try and replace. So I figured we'd just handle it at the meeting because it was
all adult too.
Light work.
Perfect. Okay, so we'll move to staff reports and go to AJ, that closes general business, City of Dacono, and we'll move to staff reports and defer to AJ.
Thank you, Mayor. As Lee mentioned, stand down day, and I guess there's an appreciation component to it as well, is Friday the 29th, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the National Guard Armory. We have this out front. We've been posting this on our Facebook page and website, so we can also help get the word out for this. There is a very brief work session right after this. No planning commission meeting tomorrow. April 25th, there'll be a joint work session with Council and Planning Commission about the comprehensive land use plan that we've kicked off end of last year. And now picking back up steam again this year. Saturday, May 14th, Dacono Night at the Races. So let me know if you want to drive a car at intermission. And the same day, Saturday the 14th, is also our clean-out day, where our residents take things over to the landfill. And that's all I have, unless there are any questions.
Questions for AJ, Council?
Do you have a status update on what's going on with the splash park down there? Are we on schedule? Or?
John, last week we talked about it. They were waiting on the parts to come in and still doing work up at the old pool, the shell of it, to see what they need to do. Because we'll probably... I don't want to get ahead of you guys, so more or less on schedule, yes.
We're hoping for Memorial Day, but may go over.
Ideally. Dan.
You're good.
Cool. Any other questions for AJ? Okay. Any other staff reports? Police Chief, Public Works, City Clerk? Seeing none, we'll go to...
Whoa.
Seeing none, we'll go to the City Council for reports and go to Carl first and ask if you have anything to report, Carl. Okay. Peggy?
Yes.
Funny you ask. This was presented to me on the 30th of March at the senior luncheon over at the Rec Center. And it's an appreciation, certificate of appreciation to the City of Dacono. Which all the other two cities or towns were given one also. But it's for recognition of our support to the Carbon Valley Parks and Recreation District Senior Program. And of course, then they asked for, and I'll pass this one down, they asked for all kinds of things, like questions. And I, in my report, of course, I told them about the, that it was the Easter program, of course, or Easter egg hunt ended up being put over here at City Hall, is that right? And that's what happened because of the snow and everything. And then the other part was about the splash park, and told them that yes, it was being taken care of, but because of the snow and everything, it set us back a little bit, and hopefully it would be finished by the 1st of June or around that time. Let's see, what else was there? Must have been something else. I don't know. But anyway, that was the report. And I was sorry the mayor couldn't have been there to receive your the plaque of appreciation. But anyway, questions that were asked were only about the grocery store.
In a good way?
Just curious.
They wanted to know who was going to go in and fill the grocery store. Things they were going out of business, discount grocery. And I knew it was going to happen, so I checked with Val before I even went to the, or before we even went to that lunch, and because I had been asked about it before, and I didn't have any answers, and Valerie told me exactly not who was going to be filling it, but their lease did not run out until October, and so therefore, that's all we knew. It was between the renter and the grocery store, and that's all I needed to tell them. And so, but people are interested in what's going to happen there.
Excellent.
Okay. Nick, do you have anything for the?
I don't have anything.
Okay.
Good here.
Kevin?
Sounds good.
Debbie?
Nothing, thanks.
Thank you, Peggy, for attending the senior.
Well, I have another thing. We're getting money, by the way. I went I-25 Coalition, and I told you about the bridges that were very, very bad out on I-25, and they're already starting to fix those bridges. Some money has come in from Tiger, and I can't give you all the what the initials stand for, but we are getting money, and some of the towns are donating. Little old Windsor, which is a very small town, is donating $1 million. Loveland is only donating $2 million for a bigger town. And so they are taking any kind of promissory, we'll pay you one of these days. I don't know if those are notes or not, but anyway, that they will help out in this endeavor to try and get this road I-25 taken care of.
So, excellent.
And that was I-25 Coalition.
Okay. I think that wraps it up then. Appreciate everyone's time tonight, Council. Seeing no other reports, we'd look for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Motion by Vogel, second by Plain. All in favor, signal by saying aye.
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 Okay. Fast and easy. Work session time for AJ.